Without a shadow of doubt, now this country can be genuinely proud of the late Fred Hollows, the famed eye surgeon who brought thousands of people literally out of the dark. Today, Fred's foundation continues to do extraordinary work with some of the poorest folk on earth, as well as inspiring new generations of doctors, like the woman you're about to meet. Here's Matt Doran.
In Africa, too often the tragedy of blindness is not that it's incurable, it's that there's no one skilled enough to help.
So which eye does he see a bit with?
On this continent, there's around one eye surgeon for every million people. Dr. Chiku Matenge is among the most remarkable. The first African female in her field to achieve a PhD, she's restoring not only sight, but vision.
In my tribe, there's a saying that don't dream, wake up and do it. You meet a blind patient today and tomorrow they can see, and yeah, it's wonderful.
Chiku has survived violent conflicts and countless civil uprisings to help give sight to thousands. She is in Australia as a guest of the Fred Hollows Foundation, speaking to medical students about healthcare in the world's poorest regions.
Doctor, it really is difficult to imagine a greater gift. What is it like when you're there, you're in that moment, and one of your patients opens their eyes and suddenly they can see again? For some, that must be an almost spiritual experience.
There was this woman, and she, when we opened her patch the next day, she looked around and she asked, which one of you is Jesus? She said, you know, she just knew that only God could restore her sight. The next woman, she was also very emotional, and she said, you know, for 5 years they've been pulling me around like a goat, I can't believe that now I can walk around by myself.
With the help of the Fred Hollows Foundation, Chiku has trained hundreds of local workers in vision-restoring lens surgery. At eye care camps across Rwanda, the workload is extraordinary.
I can easily see 50 patients every day of the week, and most of those will need surgery. The biggest problem, of course, is cataract, which, you know, can be reversed in 10 minutes.
Chiku, most of your patients are living in extreme poverty. How do they express their gratitude? How do they say thank you?
Well, they give you what they have, and sometimes it's a chicken. On a good day, it's a chicken. On other days, it's a kilo of beans.
At one camp in East Africa, a patient even produced a sack of herbs he said would miraculously deliver the doctor a baby boy.
I do have a son now. I don't think it's anything to do with those herbs. But
Fred Hollows' son, Cam, says Dr. Matenge really is an embodiment of the foundation's spirit.
In the last 5 years, we've looked in the eyes of over 6.5 million people, screening those people for just the general state of their eye care and preparing them for surgery. In 2010, we did nearly 200,000 eye operations. We've trained over 30,000 support staff.
At a time when a lot of the medical world had assumed some things are just not possible in Africa because they cost too much or the equipment costs too much, and Fred just said, no, I don't buy that.
For just $25, you too could give back someone's sight.
Which one of you is Jesus? And Matt tells us Chiku has personally helped more than 50,000 people see again. Quite an amazing feat, an amazing young woman.